Welcome friends, welcome to my another session. Today we will discuss about lockdown period. Yes, you heard right, we will discuss about lockdown period. Many of my viewers have raised concern over doing nothing, how to do time pass during this lockdown, any tips or tricks to kill the time. And many of my viewers are from civil engineering, so they are asking, Naveen, can you please share your ideas or your experience about lockdown period. So today we'll discuss how I am spending my days in lockdown here in my home. And second thing I would like to share, like, we are all belongs to construction industry, and out in that also we belongs to quality control department or quality assurance department as well. So this is, it becomes very critical to spend our day, and you know, because we are all related to site, and site is not in progress right now, it's not performing, that there is no productivity at site. So how can we utilize this lockdown as a productive lockdown? The first foremost task I would like to share with my friends is list out all ongoing activities just before the lockdown started. Just list out. By listing out, we may understand that once the lockdown opens, we are not untouched, untouched from the world. It should not be like that. We are with the world, or we are with the progress. Okay, so listing down of the activities is much important. I know that many of the activities are running back of the office, front of the office, on the site, off the field. So listing down will not make much difference. Okay, but listing down will make an impact on your present knowledge about the work or information about the progress. Next is, what are the activities once it starts requires QC interference? Okay, once you list out the activities, you will come to know many activities will be directly related to progress, will be related to documentation, whatever it is. You will bifurcate the situations, bifurcate the categories, and list out the activities. Once you list out the activities, you will come to know what are the activities which requires QC attention or QC involvement immediately once the lockdown opens. Document submissions. I know document submission officially may not be possible, but for the projects which are on digital platform, or there are many softwares nowadays the builders or the contractors or the construction companies are using, like L&T has his own software which goes on hand to hand. Like if you are using with digital platforms, try to close out the pending documents which are on your name, okay, which are assigned to you for review or closure. Or if you are able to do, if you are carrying your laptop, or if you are able to do some work or review or prepare some method statement and all, you can do that and you can upload it for client approval. That you can do. Next, NCRs. We are all very well aware that many of the times we give NCR through our heart, not through the brain, right? Like someone said, no, I will not do this, come on, give the NCR. Or sometimes someone is not listening to us, or they say that I will not attend it, give the NCR. If you are telling them two to three times, nobody is respecting your words, give the NCR. So if such NCRs are there, I am not telling that NCRs are always given on that platform, but I am just giving, if that kind of NCRs or any kind of NCRs are issued, list out the NCR issued by us to a contractor. Or if you are in a contractor, list out the NCRs which you have received through the client, right? And try to analyze them into trends. Okay, trend analysis. When you analyze the NCR issued trend, you can divide it like administrative errors or communication errors, whichever you might have come to know by this time by listening my other videos, that coordination errors or communication errors, specification errors, okay, then workmanship errors, documented evidence error, progress error. So you can analyze the issue. Most of the NCRs are falling between one particular corner or two particular corners. We don't know. So let us divide all those NCRs based on their issued trend or issued topic, right? Once you analyze the NCR, once the lockdown opens, you will be able to understand that what are the major causes of those NCRs, and as a quality control professional, you can start focusing on those causes, right? To eliminate those causes. For example, if your most of the NCRs are given on, say example, slump, right? Maybe honeycombs, honeycomb due to less slump, or many times there are two, three different errors. So you say example, your major NCRs are raised on, say, concrete rejections, right? If I am a client, I will give the NCR like many times we test the concrete, it's getting rejected, contractor has no control. Yes, I can give that as a client. Now, if I see that how many NCRs are related to concrete performance, the moment lockdown opens, I can focus on my plant, my batching plant, and I can start revamping or rescheduling or redoing the mix designs by focusing on particular aspects of that. So I will have a sufficient information or data with me to attack on the cause. Next you can do is material. List out the material approvals or material inspections your team or you have carried out. Keep a track of that and list out the entire project's requirement. As I told you that on the kickoff day or very soon after the kickoff meeting, we are expecting contractor to submit the entire vendor list or supplier list or a source of materials to the client for approval, so that we can plan our resources, we can plan our approved vendors, quality of the incoming materials, all these things we will be able to plan. Now, if you have entire project material list and we have approved material list, list out the differences like, okay, XYZ are received, ABC is by pending. Okay, once the pending list is generated by your end, you can be able to reorder it, okay, with respect to importance or urgency, right? So that once the lockdown opens, you can directly focus on contractor or as a contractor, you can focus on procurement department. Like, boss, I have listed out this ABC materials are on urgent basis, put it on priority. You understood? I know they will be also having their own priority lists, but as a quality control department, I am not asking about go and sit on procurement department's works. No, it's not like that. I am talking about prioritizing based on quality requirements or quality control requirements of the project, right? For example, say it's a very basic example. Now, before lockdown, you people as a client or a contractor, we have raised a concern over unavailability of finishing tools, right? Lockdown started, we are not focusing on it. Once lockdown is for 21 days or 25 days or whatever it is, you are going office after 24 days. And once you go after office, you forgot. From then, once you remember, then the process will start of procuring. It may take some time. So before that only, as a proactive, if you list out all these things, to-do list, and then you can start following up with your concerned department. It will be very fast and very easy for you to get these quality control equipments and tools and measuring tools with good speed, right? Try to understand this. Then, if possible, try to be, if you are in a client, try to be in contact with your contractors through official channels. Maybe writing some emails, do some meetings, online meetings. There are many apps right now available on online meetings. So try to conduct some meetings, try to brush up them, try to educate them with your available learning tools. If you have some other learning videos, share with them. Or if you are a contractor, you want to keep a good rapport with the client, keep in touch with them, share some videos in your learning platform. Obviously, if you are a contractor and if it is a reputed firm, you will have your own training and learning modules. So share with them, educate them, let them learn, because as I tell you, quality control is everyone's responsibility. Unless until you share your knowledge, share your information about quality, knowledge, okay, knowledge sharing sessions, or you can say knowledge improvement sessions, or task specific, activity specific, best practices in the world, or best practices in the industry. If you share all those things, the client or the contractor or the person in front of you will become quite familiar, will become quite friendlier, quite open to you, and together we can achieve the desired quality at the end of the project. Right? Ultimately, I'm telling you, 90% of the error, workmanship error, happens due to communication errors. So this platform, this lockdown period, you can utilize for building the communications as well. Then obviously, last but not the least, you can spare some time to improving your own knowledge by reading some books. I don't have to tell that, many social medias are all coming out with it, but I just, as a session, I'm just repeating those all same words, that build your knowledge, read books, okay, try to understand the new technology in the world. Okay, many of the countries are not at lockdown, so you can take a membership of those e-learning tools available on various platforms. I would like to share one small story. It has happened with me during my one of the technical seminars we generally attending it. There was a seminar including of two doctors. Doctor means MBBS and MS, not PhD one. So two doctors and rest are all engineers. We were a little bit confused why these doctors have come. But anyways, so there was a very experienced senior, one of the senior person, maybe retired chief engineer from any public department or something. He started to speak as a speaker, and he asked, he shared one example with everyone, that if a young doctor has been asked to solve a health issue of his patient, obviously he will ask the symptoms, he will try to open the books or ready-made material with the symptoms matching, and then he will diagnose the disease. Maybe many times they ask for many tests to understand the problem better, and then they'll diagnose and they'll send you back. Same issue if we ask to experienced doctor, say old age doctor. He will just see your nerves and he will diagnose, and many times accurately they tell that, okay, this is the situation, this is the issue, you can take this prescription, and you can take this medication. And obviously, so that sort of confidence in their subject, technology, upgradation, we can see. Now, just tell me from bottom of your heart that how many of engineers, young engineers versus old engineers, how many old engineers are better engineers than supervisors? He has asked, this question was asked by that senior, one of my senior speaker who was speaking at that time, and everyone was little bit shocked. And it's true that we entire our life of civil engineering, we spend in doing supervisory jobs, handling the resources or handling the labors. Many times, maybe educating labors in some of the respects, but yes, schedule, data collection, data upgradation, then put it into the software or make charts. Yes, we spend everything and our full of our life. We are engineers, but we spend our life in supervisors, managing the things. And to become, once we become a manager, we don't really upgrade ourselves as a technical person. We upgrade ourselves as a managerial person, right? We only believe in manage, we respond to the email, we become a postman. That one email comes, forward it to the another, another email comes. Little bit change, if it is sent by some very junior person, then modify the grammatical errors and forward it to the concerned person, right? So this is the time, this time we will not get again, right, in our lifetime. Hopefully, by God's grace, we should not get this kind of time again. But if you go in a opportunity, that this opportunity you will not get again. So let us use this opportunity to upgrade ourselves and perform better compared to our young generation. Okay, so if young generation, obviously young generation is very new, very approachable towards new technology, but as a senior generation to them, we should be far far better in techniques, technologies, tricks and engineering point of view. Okay, so you can do all this well. Please share your experiences on the comment section. Okay, be safe, stay at home and enjoy this lockdown. Thank you. Bye bye.